Ladies and gentlemen, with that, we now move on to our next panel discussion that's going to be taking place here. We have three stages. We have, this is the beta stage, of course, hashtag beta. There is the Beku stage. Make up your mind on which panel discussion you want to be part of. There's also the red couch. Feel free to interact with a whole lot of authors who are around here. With that, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to call upon Prathibha Nandakumar and Vivek Shanbhag, who will be taking us through verse and ways, poetry, truth rhymes. Yes, they are here. To tell you a little bit about Prathibha Nandakumar, she's a Bangalore-based poet, short story writer, and playwright. With 5 collections of poetry to her credit, she's presently the director of Surya Creative Services, a media service agency, and Kriya Foundation, a cultural foundation. And she's no stranger to the Bangalore Literature Festival because she won the Atta Galata Bangalore Literature Festival Award for Literary Achievement in Kannada last year. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Prathibha Nandakumar. She's going to be in conversation with Vivek Shanbhag. Mr. Vivek Shanbhag writes in Kannada. He has published 5 short story collections, 3 novels, and 2 plays, and has edited 2 anthologies. Anthologies, my bad. One of them is in English, and he's an engineer by training, Bangalore resident. Over to you, ladies and gentlemen. This is Verses and Ways, Poetry Through Times.
Good morning, everyone. Today we have Prathibha with us, and what we'll do in next half hour is have a conversation with Prathibha about her poetry, and also through that try and give you a glimpse of some of Kannada poetry, in the sense that something, you know, some of the milestones, some of the things that Prathibha has liked, and also what poets today are writing about, what they are excited about. So to start with, Prathibha has, in fact, Prathibha, was it 40 years ago that you published your first collection? Yeah, about 40 years ago. And her first collection was called Now Hudgire Hige, and she literally stormed into Kannada literary scene with that collection of poems. And what has really changed in last 40 years is that there are so many new poets who have started writing, women poets who have started writing, and also they have in a way been influenced by Prathibha, and you know, they are not they are very bold and have no inhibitions about writing, and I think that's one of the biggest contribution of Kavita Prathibha to the Kannada poetry. Anyway, Prathibha, let's start with a poem of yours. You can read a Kannada poem and then an English poem, and then we can move on from there.
Okay. Thank you very much. It's very odd to read a Kannada poem if half of the audience can everybody understand Kannada? Okay. This is called Muduki Arigidu Kalavalla. I wrote this because a young boy asked me, ಇವಾಗ ಯಾರು ಮುದುಕಿರೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಆಂಟಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದೇ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವೈಟ್ ಹೇರ್ ದೇ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಲುಕ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಓಲ್ಡ್ ವಿಮೆನ್ ದೇ ಆಲ್ ಡೈ ದೇರ್ ಹೇರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ನೋ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಲುಕ್ ಯಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಏನ್ ಅ ಸರ್ವೆ ಟೆಲ್ಸ್ ಮೀ ದಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ 3,500 ಇಮೇಜಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬಂಬಾರ್ಡೆಡ್ ಅಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ ಟು ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಟು ಯೂತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕಾಸ್ಮೆಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅವೈಲೇಬಲ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ಯು ಲುಕ್ ಯಂಗ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪೋಯಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಯುನೋ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ನರೆಕೋದಲಿಗೆ ಬಣ್ಣ ಹಚ್ಚಬೇಕು ಸ್ಟೈಲಾಗಿ ಕತ್ತರಿಸಿ ಹೊಸ ಫ್ಯಾಷನ್ ಅನುಕರಿಸಿ ಸೀರೆ ಪಕ್ಕಕ್ಕಿಟ್ಟು ಸಲ್ವಾರ್ ತೊಡಬೇಕು ಹೈಹೀಲ್ ಶೂಗಳಿಗೂ ಸೈ ಪ್ಯಾಂಟು ಧರಿಸಿದ್ದರೆ ಪ್ರತಿನಿತ್ಯ ವಂದನಾಳ VLCC ಭರತ್ ಠಾಕೂರನ ಆರ್ಟಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಯೋಗ ವಾರಕ್ಕೆರಡು ಸಲ ಫೇಷಿಯಲ್ ಕ್ಲೀನಪ್ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಕ್ಯೂರ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಸೆವೆನ್ ಡೇಸ್ ವಂಡರ್ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಸುಕ್ಕು ನಿರೋಧಕ ಕ್ರೀಮುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಮರೆಯಾಗಬೇಕು. ಅನಿವಾರ್ಯ, ಬೇರೆ ದಾರಿ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಮುದುಕಿಯರಿಗಿದು ಕಾಲವಲ್ಲ. ಹಳೆಯ ಕಾಯಕಗಳಿಗೆ ಅರ್ಥವಿಲ್ಲ. ಕತೆ ಹೇಳುವ, ಕೈತುತ್ತು ಹಾಕುವ, ಬೆಚ್ಚಗಿನ ಮಡಿಲಲ್ಲಿ ಮಲಗಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳುವ, ಸಂಡಿಗೆಯ ಉಪ್ಪಿನಕಾಯಿಗಳ ಲೋಕದಲ್ಲಿ ಕಳೆದು ಹೋಗುವ, ಆಧ್ಯಾತ್ಮದ ಮೊರೆ ಹೋಗುವ, ಇನ್ನು ಎಲ್ಲ ಮುಗಿಯಿತೆಂದು, ಇನ್ನು ಹೋಗಲು ಸಿದ್ಧರೆಂದು, ಬಚ್ಚಿಟ್ಟ ಒಡವೆಗಳನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಪೂರೈಸಿ ಮನೆಯನ್ನು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ವಾನಪ್ರಸ್ಥಕ್ಕೆ ತಯಾರಾಗುವಂತಿಲ್ಲ. ಕೈಮೈ ಸೋತರೂ ಕೊನೆ ತನಕ ದುಡಿದು ತಿನ್ನಲೇಬೇಕು. ಮುದುಕಿಯರಿಗಿದು ಕಾಲವಲ್ಲ. ಪ್ರೀತಿಸಿದ ಪುರುಷನಿಗಿನ್ನೂ ಹರೆಯದ ಹೆಣ್ಣುಗಳ ಒಡನಾಟ, ಬೇಟ, ಕಳ್ಳ ಪ್ರಣಯದ ಕದನ ಕುತೂಹಲಗಳ ಮುಂದೆ ಸೋತ ಮುಖದ ಜ್ಯೋತಮೊಲೆಯ ಸುಕ್ಕು ಕೈಗಳ ಅಸಹ್ಯ ರಾಕ್ಷಸಿ ಎನ್ನಿಸಿಕೊಳ್ಳುವ ಇಚ್ಛೆಯಿಲ್ಲದೆ ಜಾರುವ ವಯಸ್ಸಿಗೆ ಜ್ಯೋತು ಬೀಳುವ ಮುದುಕಿಯರಿಗಿದು ಕಾಲವಲ್ಲ. ಕಂಡ ಕನಸುಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ನನಸಾಗದೇ ಉಳಿದು ಭಂಡತನದಲ್ಲಿ ಬದುಕಿ ಗಂಡನನ್ನು ಸಾಕಿ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಮೀಸಲಾಗಿ ಪ್ರೇಮವು ಮರೀಚಿಕೆ ಎನಿಸಿ ಸಂಜೆಗಾಲದ ಸೂರ್ಯ ಕಾವಿಳಿದು ಬಿಸಿಲು ಕನವರಿಸಿ ಪೂರ್ಣಚಂದ್ರ ತಂಗಾಳಿ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಗೀತೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ವಿಶೇಷವೇನಿದೆ ಎಂದು ಕೇಳುವ ಮುದುಕಿಯರಿಗಿದು ಕಾಲವಲ್ಲ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನೋ ಈಚೆಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮುದುಕಿಯರಿಲ್ಲ, ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲೂ 18 ತರುಣಿಯರು ಐಟಂ ನಂಬರುಗಳಾಗಿ ಕುಣಿಯುತ್ತಿದ್ದಾರೆ.
ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ನೌ I think this is translated by you?
The same? No, I'm not reading.
Not the band. I mean...
See, some time ago they had asked me to read some poems on erotica and sensuality and things like that. So I had read this poem, and a lot of people today ask me to read this poem. So I start with this poem. It's called Defining Pleasure. If you're searching for that poem written especially for you, you have to remember that writing poems is like drinking coffee. Brewing, filtering, whitening and sweetening precedes consuming, which is actually what happens in courting. But then drinking coffee is like making love. Hot, yet not scalding. Sweet, but not too much. Enough, but not unlimited to keep going. Now, if you're thinking what I'm thinking, let's have some coffee.
Yeah, before we move on, see, there is, when we talk about the modernity in Kannada poetry, and we define that period sometime in the middle of 20th century, but there were poets who had this sensibility much before that. For example, you know, Pejavar Sadashivara. Yeah. Can you say something about that, about him, and read a few lines from his poetry?
Yeah, I remember this particular poem by Pejavar Sadashivaraya called Natyotsava. I was still a student, and C.R. Simha performed this poem in Ravindra Kalakshetra. Those were the days when poems were not performed like the way they do now. But still, the way he rendered it was, you know, it was extraordinary. And this poem has stayed with us, all of us actually. And it is very, very modern, and suddenly gave us a thought, because we were students and we were reading the classics more and not the modern poems. So I'll just read one para of that. You can see the rhythm and the way he links his thoughts to the current day and the globe at a global level. I wish I could read the whole poem, but it's very long, so I'll just read one para of it.
Prathibha, just 1 minute before you read. Pejavar Sadashiv Rao was... he died very young, and he was a geologist, and he I think he went to Italy for his higher studies, and then he fell ill and he passed away. So he has written very little but very significant, and this poem was written I think in mid-30s.
First time somebody referred to jazz music in Kannada poetry. ಲೊರೆನ್ಸೋ ಇಲ್ ಮನೀಫಿಕೋ ಹಾಡ ನರ್ಪಿಸಿ ಹೆನುತಕೋ ಇಂದಿನೆಮ್ಮ ಉತ್ಸವದಲ್ಲಿ ಯೌವನದಿ ಸಂಭ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಹರೆಯವಿದರ ಯಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಜೀವಿತಗಳ ಭೋಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಗುರುವೆ ನಿನಗೆ ಅಗ್ರಪೀಠ ಕಲಿತವೆಂದು ನಿನ್ನ ಪಾಠ ತೇಲಿ ಬರುವ ಜಾಜ್ ಗಾನ ನಿನ್ನಮ್ಮ ಕುಣಿತ ಕಲ್ಲವೇನ, ಅದೋ ದ್ರಾಕ್ಷೆ ರಸದ ಪಾನ ನಮ್ಮ ಕುಡಿತ ಕಲ್ಲವೇನ, ವೆನಿತ್ಸೆಯದ ಕಡೆಯ ಗಾಜೋ ಸಾರ್ದೇನಿಯದ ಸುರೆಯ ಮೋಜೋ ಮುತ್ತಿರುವರೆ ಕತ್ತಲು ಹಾಡಿನೊಡನೆ ಮೂಡಿ ಬರುವ ಬೇರೆ ನಾಡ ಕನಸ ತರುವ ಸೌರಭದಲ್ಲಿ ಎತ್ತಲು.
See, a little around the same time, or maybe a little after that, is K.S. Narasimha Swami, who came into the Kannada literary scene with his Mysuru Mallige. And today he is very, very popular, one of the most popular Kannada poets. And Prathibha, if I can ask you to, yeah, you know, read a few lines from Narasimha Swami.
See, there are so many poems of K.S. Narasimha Swami which people think are folk songs. In fact, he himself narrated that whenever he went into a bus stand or train, people would be singing, the beggars would be singing, and they would tell him that it is a folk song, but it was his poem actually. So even now, if I read these poems, some people may think it is folk poem, especially this ಒಂದಿರುಳ ಕನಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ ನನ್ನವಳ ಕೇಳಿದೆನು ಚಂದನಿನಗಾವುದೆಂದು, ನಮ್ಮೂರು ಹೊನ್ನೂರು ನಿಮ್ಮೂರು ನವಿಲೂರು ಚಂದನಿಮಗಾವುದೆಂದು, ನಮ್ಮೂರು ಚಂದವೋ ನಿಮ್ಮೂರು ಚಂದವೋ ಎಂದೆನ್ನ ಕೇಳಲೇಕೆ, ನಮ್ಮೂರ ಮಂಚದಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಮೂರ ಕನಸಿದನು ವಿಸ್ತರಿಸಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕೆ. ಸೊ
No,
I'll just read a couple of lines from his Nee Vallave. This is also another poem that people think is a folk song. Hattu varshada hinde muttura terinalli attitta sulidavaru Nee Vallave, hattirada hennendu matte mutturinalli oppi kai hididavaru Nee Vallave.
And moving on, I think it's around 1950s that Gopal Krishna Adiga, who wrote poems in a completely different way and brought in what we call a Navya movement in Canada, the modernist movement. And Prathibha, if you can please read a few lines. And I'm requesting Prathibha to read one of his poems in translation.
See, this is called Sumbane. ಏನಾದರೂ ಮಾಡುತ್ತಿರು ತಮ್ಮ. ನಾವು ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ರೀಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಸೋ ರೆಲೆವೆಂಟ್ ಈವನ್ ನೌ, ಯು ನೋ. ಡೂ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ರದರ್, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಎ ಕೆ ರಾಮಾನುಜನ್. ಡೂ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ರದರ್, ಕೀಪ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್, ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್, ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಐಡಲ್. ಪುಲ್ ಔಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್, ನಿಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಲೀವ್, ಕ್ರಶ್ ದಟ್ ಫ್ಲವರ್, ದಿಸ್ ಗ್ರಾಸ್, ರನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಇಟ್, ಬರ್ನ್ ಇಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಲಂಕಾ. Tiny butterflies, parrots, sparrows, chase them, catch them, pluck their wings, pull out their fur and feather. There in the garden, jasmine and the banana's gold grow for the wild elephant's feet. All over the walls, virility's master switches itch your fingers. Close your eyes and pull down 20 of them. Earth, water, the skies, they're all your geese with golden eggs. Gouge them out, slash them. Do or die, they say. Disasters are the test for your genius's galloping dance. Something must crash every minute. Brother, act at once, do something. Thoughts, weights, and measures are all for the past, for the undying ghostly treasures of the dead. There's the forest, cut it clean to the stump. Slit it for your buntings. You have the axe, the sickle, the saw, and the knife. Go, harvest all the world with a flourish of your hand. But you meet winter mists, walls of fog, walls that line the space between face and face, and the road that sighs and the breaks in two under your eyes, a couple of mountain peaks that rear their hoods and lower upon your head, or lightning winds from sirens that sing in every tree. Do they plunge you into anxieties and dilemmas of reason? No, this won't do. You're a simple man, and that's your strength. Horse sense and the blinkers of all your forte. Then there's the well of life. Rope the wheel and axle. Pull out all the water. Reach the last dryness of the raw. Groove, group with the grappling iron. V for victory, brother. Break down the atom. Reach for the ultimate world within. Find God's own arrow and aim it straight at the heart of God's own embryo world. Do something, anything, anything, brother. Idle men are burdens on the land. Do, brother. Go do something. Keep doing something all the time to lessen Mother Earth's load, to lighten Mother Earth's load. This is right. This is natural. This is the only thing needful. So I think the sarcasm in Kannada was very good. I think Ekinamanujan has done a fantastic translation to bring that in English as well.
So, yeah, around the same time, though there was a modernist movement, but the other poets stopped writing and following this. Kannada is a very diverse, has a very diverse literary landscape, and many other poets who followed a different path were also writing and very active. And one of them is S.R. Ekundi, and Puthi Narasimhachar, who is one of our great poets. His play, which is a musical called Gokula Nirgamana, became very, very popular. And some of the songs in that play, I consider some of the best, they are some of the best love songs. Moving on to the 70s is when Prathibha started writing, and also when K.V. Thirumlesh came onto the scene, and he changed, as Adiga changed completely the way you look at Kannada poetry, K.V. Thirumlesh also changed, he brought in a step change. There was a different language, different metaphors, the way of saying, everything was different, and that influenced a whole lot of poets in the next two or three decades to come. So Prathibha, if you can read one of his poems in translation.
Actually, this face-to-face mukha-mukhi, I really wish I could read it in Kannada. But I'm reading it in English. It is A.K. Ramanujan's translation again. And Thirumlesh is here. I wish you could hear it from his voice. A fat cat came into my drawing room, looked at me, and stopped short. Perhaps it didn't expect me there. Certainly not on a Monday afternoon when everybody is at the office. It looked at me reproachfully. Our eyes met in an undeclared war on who should turn away first. I didn't know a cat's eye could be so still. Stiff tail lifted, back hair bristling, claws drawn in. All in all, the cat was tight as a bow and occupied my entire field of vision as if I had lost my way, had fallen on prehistoric continents on unknown seas. But I didn't blink an eyelid. The cat didn't blink an eyelid either. In a special state, basic to man and beast, the cat stood all cat in front of me. I didn't know a cat's eyes could be such orphans. In the end, it was the beast that lost. At least I thought so. The stiff body relaxed slowly. The cat slinked away like a cat. My field of vision suddenly empty. It occurred to me, I could have accepted the cat's respect for its cat self. What did I gain after all? One should win like Bahubali, by yielding, by giving up. I didn't know a cat's eyes could contain so much grief.
Wonderful, thank you. Just before coming here, Prathibha and I were talking about how, even in 70s, 60s and 70s, there was absolutely no inhibition for Kannada poets to take up anything and write. And one of the examples is a poem called Lambretta Vespa, I think written in sometime in early 70s, by someone called Nalini Deshpande. So request Prathibha to read this in Kannada.
I think we need to tell you that, see, the modern Kannada poetry, especially the women, were not writing poetry. And when Lankesh wanted to bring out one anthology of modern Kannada, the best of modern Kannada poems, they didn't have a woman. There was no woman's voice at all. So somebody, they say it could be Purnachandra Tejasvi, or it could be Sumatindra Nodi, somebody. Some man wrote two poems as a woman, and they called it Nalini Deshpande. And those two poems are so good. Like even now, they're so futuristic. If I read it, in fact, the other day I had to address a meeting in on a platform which was filled with the right-wing people, you know. So anything you talk about Hinduism or anything, they would, you know, raise their voice and fight. So I read out this poem and say, just 50 years ago, 40 years ago, we could write like this. And nobody thought any bad of it. We could criticize. We could be the insider critiques, you know. We could still voice such thoughts. But now it has become so difficult to write like this. I really want to read this. Lambretta Vespa. ಸರ್ವರ ಸಮ್ಮತ ಸಂತೆಯ ದಾರಿ ಟಾಯ್ಲೆಟ್ ಸೋಪಿನ ಪ್ರಚಾರ ಮೋಡಿ ಹೋದದು ಹೋಯ್ತು ವಾದದ್ದಾಯ್ತು ಒಳಿತೋ ಕೆಡಕೋ ಏನೇ ಇರಲಿ ತುಂಟ ಹುಡುಗನ ಸೊಂಟ ಸುತ್ತಿ ಲ್ಯಾಂಬ್ರೆಟಾ ವೆಸ್ಪಾ ಬೆನ್ನನು ಹತ್ತಿ ಕೀಲು ಕುದುರೆ ರಾಜಕುಮಾರಿ ಒಮ್ಮೆಯಾದರೂ ಅದೇನು ನರಕಕ್ಕೂ ಹೋದೇನು ಗ್ರಹಗತಿ ಓದುವ ಬ್ರಾಹ್ಮಣರೆಲ್ಲ ಸತ್ತೇ ಹೋಗಲಿ ವಿಪ್ಲವದಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂಧು ಬಾಂಧವರಿಷ್ಟರ ಗೊಟ್ಟಿಯ ಚಂದನ ಕಾಷ್ಟ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರಿ ಬೆಂಕಿಯ ಸುಟ್ಟೇ ಹೋಗಲಿ ಹಿಂದೂ ಧರ್ಮ ತುಂಟ ಹುಡುಗನ ಸೊಂಟ ಸುತ್ತಿ ಲ್ಯಾಂಬ್ರೆಟಾ ವೆಸ್ಪಾ ಬೆನ್ನನು ಹತ್ತಿ ಕೀಲು ಕುದುರೆ ರಾಜಕುಮಾರಿ ಒಮ್ಮೆಯಾದರೂ ಆದೇನು ನರಕಕ್ಕೂ ಹೋದೇನು ಶತಶತಮಾನದ ಮುಗಿಯದ ಬವಣೆಗೆ ಯಾರುದ್ದಾರಕೋ ನವನವೆದವರೇ ನೆಂಟರಿಷ್ಟರು ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮರ ಸರ್ಪಾಕಾಂಕ್ಷೆಗೆ ಸೊಪ್ಪಾದವರೇ ತುಳಸಿ ಕಟ್ಟೆಯ ಸುತ್ತೇ ಸುತ್ತುವ ಹೆಡ್ಡ ಜೋಯಿಸ ನಿಲ್ಲಿಸು ಪ್ರವರ ತುಂಟ ಹುಡುಗನ ಸೊಂಟ ಸುತ್ತಿ ಲ್ಯಾಂಬ್ರೆಟಾ ವೆಸ್ಪಾ ಬೆನ್ನನು ಹತ್ತಿ ಕೀಲು ಕುದುರೆ ರಾಜಕುಮಾರಿ ಒಮ್ಮೆಯಾದರೂ ಆದೇನು ನರಕಕ್ಕೂ ಹೋದೇನು ಜಾತಕ ಚಾತಕ ನಾನಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಸಾಕೋ ಸಾಕು ಸಾಕೋ ಸಾಕು ಜೀವನವೆಲ್ಲ ನಶ್ವರವೆನ್ನುವ ಹಿಂದೂ ಧರ್ಮವೇ ಹೀಗಾದಾಗ ಯಾರುಳಿದೇನು ಯಾರಳಿದೇನು ಅನಿಸಿದ್ದೆಲ್ಲ ಹಾಗೇ ಬಿಡಲಿ ಆಟಂ ಬಾಂಬಿನ ಅಣುಸಮರಕ್ಕೆ ನಾಂದಿಯಾದರೂ ನನಗೇನಿಲ್ಲ ತುಂಟ ಹುಡುಗನ ಸೊಂಟ ಸುತ್ತಿ ಲ್ಯಾಂಬ್ರೆಟಾ ವೆಸ್ಪಾ ಬೆನ್ನನು ಹತ್ತಿ ಕೀಲು ಕುದುರೆ ರಾಜಕುಮಾರಿ ಒಮ್ಮೆಯಾದರೂ ಆದೇನು ನರಕಕ್ಕೂ ಹೋದೇನು
I think we have 5 more minutes. So before we close and before I request Prathibha to read some of her poems in English, I want to say a few things about other poets, other most important poets like Kambar, who brought in the music, the folk music into Kannada poetry. And Kambar, as you know, is one of our most significant poets. And then there were many others, and someone like Siddhlingaya, who is a Dalit poet, who is again one of the most powerful poets of Kannada. And then there were others, younger generation. I'm not going to name all of them, but it is very, the scene, the Kannada poetry scene is very vibrant, and people, the poets, they interact with each other. And most importantly, they quarrel with each other. And Prathibha, I must say, has a distinction of quarreling with every writer in Kannada. So Prathibha, may I request you to read, I think we have time for two poems, short ones.
Two poems?
Yeah, I think till they stop us, we can go on reading.
Okay. Now I'll try to read some short ones. Eve. I am no Eve, he was no Adam. No snake, no Eden, certainly no apple. To eat, I never tempted him, yet had committed a sin. What is temptation and what is food is for him to see. As for me, I never needed a snake to advise me. Okay, Isaac Mizrahi, the fashion designer, once said, You are shirking your responsibility as a woman if you don't sometimes wear high heels, do your hair, and wear a bit of pink. This poem is called Pink. The untimely doorbell brings me hurrying in bare minimum, and he stands there, the God Almighty, all dressed up in expensive silks. It was no wardrobe malfunction, my torn nightie, untidy hair. Does my mouth smell? Did I wash between legs? Why are we discussing some godforsaken seminar, goofed up by some good-for-nothing idiot who should have been kicked out but given a promotion and an award too? The coffee comes to rescue, and the mug is big enough, but allows an unintentional touch, and then everything changed. That carpet, the windowsill, the afternoon sun, that blaring music from the next door, cart vendors calling out fresh tomatoes, nothing was color pink. He mouthed an impromptu poem on my brown lips, my flat feet, and of course on my thick, dark eyelashes. Okay, I'll just read some small ones. An Eskimo belief says, when you sleep, the soul comes out of the body and dangles by the big toe upside down and gets back into the body when you wake up. So this is called a soul and sleep. The fat bodies have fat souls, which are too heavy to dangle by the toe upside down. If it were thumb, it's a different matter. We have a tradition of asking thumbs as Guru Dakshina, you see. The soul should know this and beware. And also it should be informed that we Indians take refuge in sleep and soul and blame it for everything, including when we are not able to fake it. Which is better, orgasm or to be left alone when not in mood? The debate caused a rift lasting 3 days of silence and fasting. Finally giving in, she said it was the Eskimo belief that rescued her, and the only difference is that here the soul does not dangle upside down.
Prathibha, can I request you to read one last poem in Kannada? And after that, we end.
Okay, I'll read one poem which usually people ask me to read. It's called Adige Madutiddene. This I wrote. You know, on TV channels, we have cookery shows that goes like this. 1 kilo potato tagoli, boil madi, peel madi, mash madi, 3 inch ginger tagoli, grate madi, 5 green chilies tagoli, cut madi, ella mix madi, fry madi, serve madi. So this poem is a tribute to that kind of Kanglish. Adige madutiddene. Gas, mixer, grinder, toaster, grater, heater, peeler, washer, grihiniya pradhana consumer. Nenne angadiyalli, indu maneyalli, naale. ಕ್ಲೀನ್ಡ್ ರೈಸು, ದಾಲು, ಪ್ಯಾಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪುಡಿ, ಹಿಡಿ, ಹಿಟ್ಟು, ಪಟ್ಟು, ಬೆಂದ, ಬೇಯಿಸಿದ, ಹುರಿದ, ಕರಿದ, ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ 108 ಪ್ಯಾಕೆಟ್ಟು ಎಲ್ಲ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಬರೀ ಕತ್ತರಿಸಿದರೆ ಸಾಕು, ನೀರು ಬೆರೆಸಿದರೆ ಸಾಕು, ಬಿಸಿ ಮಾಡಿದಂತೆ ತಿಂದರೆ ಸಾಕು, ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಬರೀ ಕತ್ತರಿಸಿದ ಸಾಕು, ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ತಿಂದರೆ ಸಾಕು. ಅಜ್ಜಿ ಮುತ್ತಜ್ಜಿಯರ ರೆಸಿಪಿಗಳ ಮುಖ ನಿವಾಳಿಸುವಂತೆ ನೂಡಲ್ಸ್, ಗೀಡಲ್ಸ್, ಪಿಜ್ಜಾ, ಫ್ರೆಂಚ್ ಫ್ರೈ, ಚಾಪ್ಸ್, ಶೆಜುವಾನು, ಮೇಜುವಾನು, ನಾರ್ತ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್, ಕಾಂಟಿನೆಂಟಲ್, ಬಸವನಗುಡಿಯ ಇಟಾಲಿಯನ್ ಐಸ್ ಕ್ರೀಮು, ನಮ್ಮೂರ ಹೋಟೆಲ್, ಬಿಸಿ ಬಿಸಿ ಸೇಲ್ಸ್. ಯಾಕೆ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಸೆಂಟಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಹೋಗಲಿ ಬಿಡಿ, ಒಂದಷ್ಟು ಕ್ರಿಮಿನಾಶಕ, ಹೊಟ್ಟೆಗೆ ಕಲಬೆರಕೆ, ಪಾತಕ, ಬಾಟಲು ಪಾನಕ, ಇದೇನು ಮಹಾನರಕ, ಜಗತ್ತೇ ಬಾಯಿ ಹರಕ. ರಿಫೈನ್ಡ್, ಫಿಲ್ಟರ್ಡ್, ಪ್ರೋಸೆಸ್ಡ್, ಕಲ್ಚರ್ಡ್, 6 ತಿಂಗಳೊಳಗೆ ತಿನ್ನಿ, 3 ವಾರ ಹಾಗೆ ಇಡಬಹುದು, 2 ತಿಂಗಳು ಫ್ರಿಡ್ಜಿನಲ್ಲಿಡಿ, ನಾಳೆಯೊಳಗೆ ತಿಂದು ಮುಗಿಸಿ. ಹಿಮಾಲಯ ಹತ್ತುವವರು ಇದನ್ನೇ ತಿನ್ನುತ್ತಾರೆ, ಮಹಡಿ ಹತ್ತಲಾರದವರು ಇದನ್ನೇ ತಿಂದು ಕೊಬ್ಬುತ್ತಾರೆ ನೋಡಿ. ಇಷ್ಟು ಮಾಡಲಾಗದವರು 2 ಚಮಚ ಪುಡಿ ಬಾಯಿಗೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟಿಕೊಂಡು ಗಾಳಿ ಕುಡಿದೆ ಬದುಕಿ, 4,800 ರೂಪಾಯಿಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿಟಮಿನ್ನು, ಪ್ರೋಟೀನು, ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಬೆಳಗ್ಗೆ ಸಂಜೆ ಜಿಮ್ಮಿಗೆ 600, ನಿಂತ ಕಡೆಯೇ ನಡಿಗೆ, ಕರೀನಾ ಕಪೂರ್ ವೇಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಬೇಕು ಬೇಕು. ಡಾಕ್ಟರು, ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರು, ಆರ್ಟಿಸ್ಟು, ಸೈಂಟಿಸ್ಟು, ಜರ್ನಲಿಸ್ಟು, ಲೇಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೆಲ್ಲು, ಟಿವಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಾಟ್ ಫೇವರೇಟ್ ಹಿಟ್ಟು. ಮತ್ತ್ಯಾಕೆ ಬಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೋ ಏನೋ, ಸಾಯಲು ಪುರ್ಸತ್ತಿಲ್ಲದೆ ಇವತ್ತು ಬೆಳಗಾಗೆದ್ದು ಅಡುಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ, ಸುಡುಗಾಡು ಯಾವುದೋ ಹಬ್ಬ ಅಂತೆ, ಏನೋ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಂತೆ. ಅಡುಗೆ ಮಾಡುತ್ತಿದ್ದೇನೆ 2. ಅಡಿಗೆ ಮಾಡುವುದೆಂದರೆ ಬಹಳ ಇಷ್ಟ ನನಗೆ. ಹೊರದಾರಿ ಅದು ನನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಆಕ್ರೋಶಗಳಿಗೆ. ತೊಳೆದು ಸಿಪ್ಪೆ ಸುಲಿದು ಕತ್ತರಿಸಿ ಜಜ್ಜಿ ಕುಟ್ಟಿ ಹುರಿದು ಅರಿದು ರುಬ್ಬಿ ನುರಿದು ಬಾಡಿಸಿ ಬೇಯಿಸಿ ಹಿಚಕಿ ಮಸೆದು ಕೊಚ್ಚಿ ಕಲಸಿ ಗಸಗಸನೆ ಕಡೆದು ಎತ್ತಿ ಹಾಕಿದರೆ ತಟ್ಟೆಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ರುಚಿ ರುಚಿ ಅಂತ ತಿನ್ನುತ್ತಾರೆ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಪ್ರತಿಭಾ.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, we have room for two quick questions, if anyone has any. Sir, you direct me and I will take questions. Yes, ma'am.
This is not a question. I wanted to thank you both, Vivek and Prathibha, for giving us this. It's been literary, it's been beautiful, and both of you have brought a woman's voice into this festival. I'm truly grateful.
Thank you.
That was a compliment.
Actually we had selected a lot of poems by A.K. Ramanujan and other poems of Tirumalesh and others, but the short of...
I think we could give you a glimpse of what it is, and if it can generate interest in Kannada poetry, I think then our objective is achieved. And thank you very much for being with us today.
Right, we have one more question. One quick question. Who would you like to take it from? Yes.
Ma'am, your most influential poem, like whenever you're upset or happy or whatever your emotions are, if you read that, you'll feel joy. That kind of poem.
Not sure if we have time for another poem.
No, ma'am. I'm asking, like, which poem you like?
Me?
Yeah. Who's any poet?
Other poets?
Yeah.
Oh, it's a long list. You know, I mean, it can't be just one poet that you like. I'm an old woman, you see. So there are lots of poets I read. I read A.K. Ramanujan, and I read world poets. I read a lot of Indian poets. So there are, you pick up different kinds of poets depending on your mood, right? So I read sometimes classics. I read folk. I read the modern contemporary. In fact, I'll be having an LGBT Kannada literature session in the evening. So even their poems are very good. You will get to hear them in the evening. So
thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Prathibha Nandakumar and Vivek Shanbhag. Thank you once again.